Hey guys, how's it going? I'm here with Juan David. So today we're gonna talk about different experiences, right? About his life. First of all, we're gonna talk about his experience at the military school Jose Maria Cordova in Boulder, right?
Yes, of
course. Okay. Second, we're gonna talk about his experience studying medicine in Boulder. And third, we're gonna talk about his experience taking lessons here at PUC, getting ready for the international test, ITEP. So tell us about those experiences.
Okay, thanks teacher. Hi guys. First of all, thanks teacher for giving the opportunity to share my experience.
Okay.
I'm gonna talk about the experience in Bogota. I lived in Bogota since 2016. And I entered to Jose Maria Cordova Military School on July. It's very difficult, yeah. Bogota is a city,
very stressful as well, right?
Very stressful, yes. What do you think about Bogota, the capital of Colombia?
Yeah, for example, like according to my point of view, I can say that Bogota is really stressful, as I told you. Because as you know, it's a big city, so a lot of people from different cities from Colombia live in there. So that's why that it's overpopulated, we can say. And that's why that maybe tends to be like stressful. And I think like in there, you need to wake up so early, right?
Yes.
What time, for example, what time do you normally wake up in there?
In the army, you must wake up at 5 a.m. o'clock. It's so early.
Yeah, it's too early. For example, like in here, I can say in Paso, I normally wake up like 6:30 or 10 past 7, for example. But in Bogota, 5 o'clock is too early. And as you know, it's freezing in there.
Yes.
So I suppose like to wake up at that hour.
Yes, the weather is very cold. And when you wake up, you must take a shower for the reason the water in Bogota is extremely cold.
And for example, like I can say that after taking a shower, you start like shaking or something like that, right?
Yes, of course. All the cadets, every day.
And yes. I suppose after like taking the shower as well, you just want like to continue sleeping.
No. You take a shower and immediately you get dressed and you go to the restaurant in the military school to eat the breakfast and immediately to go to the barracks and to you must
do
clean the bedroom
and
yes,
just to do the normal activities.
Yes, normal activities every day. Every day in the military school, all kind of activities. You can go to sleep, or you can go to the swim to relax. It's impossible.
Yeah, for example, we can say that that's like a serious aspect in there because, as you know, it's related to discipline. Yeah, I suppose that, for example, in the army, the discipline is a great factor. Right?
Yes. Discipline is very important in the military life because if you can make all kind of things very well in the army, you must apply the discipline. The discipline is very important in military life and in the normal life, right?
Yeah.
What do you think about
all that? Yeah, for example, like normally here at PUC, in the experience talking about PUC, I think that the discipline is an important aspect because the people need to be willing to learn something. And if you want to learn something, for example, you need to be a disciplined person, a conscientious person, right?
Yes.
So I think in the army or whatever place is the same, right?
Yes, of course. Discipline is very important in the military life. For example, in my case, when I studied in second semester, I had the opportunity to study medicine in Nueva Granada Military University.
Okay.
But this is a big responsibility, and I apply more discipline than when I studied in the first semester, when I entered to the military school, because at the beginning, this is only the military career. Now is military career and medicine career. It's very difficult.
So we can say that Juan David is a great example for those people that want to start, because he's starting two careers at the same time, and as you know, that's a complex process, right?
Yes, of course.
Imagine that, for example, he told me once at the beginning of the course, for example, here at work, that he's normally just sleeping like around like 2 or 3 hours, more or less.
Yes, of course. At the beginning, it was difficult because I don't have time for too many things, and sometimes I can't sleep, and I can't sleep at night.
And for example, what do you normally do, for example, like to have the same energy, for example, because as you know, it's complex, like just to sleep just 2 hours and 3 hours is nothing.
Yes.
Because as you know, it's recommendable like to sleep like at least 6 hours, between 6 and 7 hours, right?
Yes, it's important to sleep, but in normal time to sleep is 5 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours. But
okay.
In my case, I slept only 2 hours or sometimes 1 hour. For that reason, it's very important.
And but for example, like when you were starting, I don't know, for example, if I sleep just 2 hours or 3 hours, I feel so sleepy the next day, and I just want like to sleep on the table, for example.
Yes, in the beginning, when I studied, and I arrived the lunch time, normally, I was normal, but...
Along the time,
when I arrived to third semester, for example, it's very difficult, for example, when arrive the lunch time and the next and I arrive to the next class, I fell asleep,
of course,
every day. And for that reason, I drink coffee every day.
Yeah, for example, like we consider you are starting medicine. I suppose that you are taking like some vitamins in order like, to get over and to feel like more energetic. Right.
Yes, of course, very important. Yeah, you the students, I consider that all the students an extremely life or an stressful life.
Exactly.
You should eat healthy food. Eat vitamins. Therefore, get energy. Of course.
For example, like talking about healthy food, what do you consider is like healthy food?
Yeah, in my opinion, the healthy food is the food that has vitamins, has proteins, for instance, meat, eggs, milk, cheese is very important, but and the most people have this different style of life, yeah?
Okay,
most of the people like, for example, the fast food. The fast food is very delicious, but it's unhealthy.
Yeah, for example, like talking about the fast food, I consider that the fast food can be like useful, like in some aspects, if you eat like twice a week or three times a week or twice a month.
Sometimes it's good because the healthy food, the most of healthy food are not very delicious, but if you compare between the fast food and the healthy food, the fast food is obvious, it's more delicious than the
healthy food. Yeah, exactly.
For that reason, you should eat the fast food sometimes, one or twice in the week.
And what about, for example, like that you live in there, right, in the military school? What about the fast food or healthy food? Okay. Is easier like to eat fast food or healthy food in there?
In the army, all the cadets, the most of the cadets love the fast food, of course, because in the military school, the food aren't a quality. It's not a good quality for that reason.
Why, for example, why? What do you normally eat in there?
Because it's a portion could be, and for example, a breakfast, or Monday, for example, the breakfast is a coffee with a bread.
No more.
For the lunch is good. The dinner, so. For that reason, the cadets go to the restaurant in military school, and some cadets does engineer that, and then go to the mall, go to the small mall in
order to have fast food.
Yeah, in order to fast food and pizza, hot dogs, hamburger. Yes.
Okay. That is like a complex aspect in there, right?
Yes,
in the military school. And I suppose, what about you, for example? You are that kind of person that it says, okay, this breakfast is nothing for me, just coffee and bread. I just want like to get something else. Do you normally head to the mall like to get even more food?
No, in my case it's different because I go to the university every day. For that reason, I leave from my military school. And for example, if there is a day that the breakfast is so-so or bad,
okay.
I prefer to eat the breakfast outside,
exactly.
In the university, for example, because in Bogota there are a lot of places, that you can find a better option for eat the breakfast or for eat everything.
On the other hand, for example, like talking about a military school that it's like very, we can say, disciplined in that aspect. So we can say that the soldiers, the cadets, have the opportunity, for example, to hang out, to go out on weekends, for example, like to go to a disco?
Yes.
It's easier?
Yes. It's normally that every weekend all the cadets go out to relax. Yeah, for example, from Friday to Sunday,
okay.
Or from Saturday to Sunday, only one day. Or sometimes from Friday to Monday.
Okay, my friends, so tell us about your experience studying medicine.
Okay, I began studying medicine in 2017.
Okay.
When I was studying in third semester in José María Córdoba Military School.
Okay.
For that reason, I consider that it was a big responsibility and very demanding because the José María Córdoba Military School has a rules for the commission.
Okay.
For example, in my case, I can lose a subject in Nueva Granada Military University, but
yes.
In this case, it's very difficult because medicine is a extremely difficult career, but in my opinion, it's a wonderful opportunity to learn about yourself because you can learn the normal function or the human body. For that reason, it's very important, but you discover very things that you don't imagine. That
okay.
In my case is demanding.
Okay.
How about you, teacher? What do you think about the person that have the opportunity to study two careers at the same time?
As we were talking before, it's complex because of the time. The time is limited, I can say. So I think that it depends on attitude and it depends on discipline as well. If you're willing to learn like two careers at the same time, yeah, it's okay. And it depends on yourself, of course. And I think apart from that is necessary, for example, like sometimes, like basically the weekends, like to rest like for a couple of hours, because you need to recover the energy as well, in order like to work very well with your status, right? And on the other hand, I consider that, for example, basically, when the people learn two careers at the same time, they take advantage of themselves, right? Because they have like a higher rank than the other people.
Yes, yes, of course, I agree with you, teacher, in the part of the time. The time is very important because in this case, or in my case,
and
I don't have time.
You don't have free time, and your
yes.
time is valuable.
Right? It's very important because you want to sleep 6 hours, for example, but you can only 2 hours.
Sleep just 2 hours, and yes, that's all demanded, right?
Or 1 hour. It's very difficult for that.
Yes. Okay. And talking about, for example, like the English language that you had the great opportunity to study here at Puck, and it was my pleasure to work with you, basically. Tell us like a little bit about that experience, like in here.
Yes, English is very important. In my case, medicine is very important. The most articles and most investigations is in English languages. For that reason, I had the opportunity to study with Puck, exactly. And I consider that it was a wonderful experience because Puck has a fun method to teach English for the students, and in Puck you can learn English in very fun and very quickly. This is important, but in my case I had the opportunity to present an international test. This is ITEP test, but in my case I had a good result, a good score.
That's good enough, the
B2 level, but in my opinion is a good experience for that, and the teacher tell us about that, but he is the expert about the topic, the English levels and the English languages.
Okay, so I can tell you, for example, about that experience, about the ITEP, that it was so rewarding, like, to work with Juan David, because from the beginning he was willing like to get a higher score. Fortunately, we got the B2 level with him, and this test is basically related to assess the students in different skills like grammar, listening, reading, speaking and writing. And we developed like a great process in here because we were working along the time, along this month, like basically combining the different skills like listening, reading, speaking and writing, and that's why that we got the B2 level. And I recommend like all those people that want like to sit the ITEP test here, because Puck is a center, ITEP center here in Paso, like to sit the test, because it's important like to assess the skills, right? Because some people, maybe sometimes they claim that they speak a lot and they have like a lot of skills in their minds, English skills in this case, but sometimes it's not like that. I think that basically you need to assess your skills in this case if you have that opportunity, like Juan David, that fortunately we got the B2 level, and is gonna be, that certificate is gonna be so helpful for him in his future life and the professional life, in this case, right? Okay, my friend, so tell us, how do you feel, for example, like learning English by playing games?
Yes, of course. Yeah, in my opinion, I consider that is a good or excellent method for learn English. For example, Puck has different games. For example, Monopoly. With Monopoly, you can learn a different vocabulary. Yes, or Bingo. Bingo is a fun game, and you can learn with Bingo comparative or superlatives. Yes, okay. Or I had the opportunity to play Uno and learn phrasal verbs. Yeah, is very important phrasal verbs, because the most American people
With
the phrasal verbs. The informal English is exactly basically with phrasal verbs. Exactly. For that reason, I consider that, or I recommend you visit a Puck, come here and learn English faster and fun. Yeah.
Okay. So I think that's it for today, guys. Thanks for watching this video. See you next time. Bye.
Yes. Take care. See you.